All right, welcome back to Your Balanced Diet of Teletainment. Now, we know say there's been a lot of people coming out to say time don't reach for youths to take over the governance of Nigeria. Now, we get a lot of youths coming out to indicate their interest in being the presidential aspirants come 2019 election. Now, one particular person will stand out in the midst of this youth, now a woman, yes, a 39-year-old woman, where they come as I talk, say, I am ready to make a change in our policy for inside Wilbodo, Nigeria, even though I am a woman. Make I just give you a little brief of her profile. Now, she studied agricultural economics for inside University of Ibadan for your state, business administration for inside Germany. She's happy to speak German, Spanish, and different other language according by the her profile. Now, she's happy to speak. And plenty of things where she don't actually involve herself into, like filmmaking, acting, and communication skills she don't get time for inside United States of America, and plenty other qualifications. And join me, welcome, a legal practitioner, a businesswoman, and now our prospective female candidate, presidential candidate, come 2019 election, Eunice Adjuetejide. Inside the studio. Good to have you.
Thank you very much. Say on that they speak broken, they speak English.
They speak broken, all of them.
Even if I put it there now, it is okay.
Yes, good time.
I'm on a perfect something now.
All right, now, so from the profile, we don't see, say, you study agriculture, economics, and some of the other qualifications we get. Mm. We actually, in the media, when I look at media, I talk about entertainment industry.
Yeah.
Which experience will you don't gather to actually qualify you as a presidential aspirants for inside the political arena come 2019 for Nigeria?
I've got a lot of experiences. I have very easily transferable skills, whether you're thinking about analytical skills as a lawyer, whether you're thinking about groundworks and ability to negotiate as a business person, whether you're thinking about the procurement areas where you have to actually look for goods and services that best serve the purpose of your clients and make sure you're purchasing them at the best rates possible. So there are so many different skills in all the things I've done in my life, including raising all those wonderful independent children. You're going to be balancing interest, balancing the reasons that you have to make a decision that favors everybody. So when you pick all of that and you dump it in one box, then you realize that compared to all the people we have seen in our political arena, I'm one of the champions when it comes to experience and ability to like navigate different interests and different issues and then arrive at central points where a decision can be made that favors every corner. So indeed, I have a lot of experience from work, from my relationships with people, from my travels all over the world, quite a lot of experience that will be directly transferable as the the president of the Federal Republic of.
So talking about experience. Now, yes. A lot of people do have the opinion, say, especially for youths, now it's not just to you, but for youths, where they actually go into the presidential election come 2019, why that seat? Why not start from being a local government chairman or start with your immediate community and let's see how much impact you can make before going forward to be a presidential candidate? So to you now, why the presidential seat?
For me personally, it's about your capacity, your ability, and what have you prepared for. All my life, I have prepared for the presidency. It would be very stupid to say, oh, because Nigerians expect you to go and start in your local government area, then do so. That would not favor me. It would not favor my country. So what I have done for myself is to absolutely look at what I have set out to do in my life and how I have programmed myself to develop myself and to help the country. I didn't develop myself or my space in such a way that I would be useful in the local government area or do better as a state governor or do better as a senator. I have programmed my life to work for the presidency and I've been doing that since I was 7. So I wouldn't come around and change it because Nigerians or people think it's better to start small. I don't do things because of the way people see it. I really
why
think about it.
Why would that help the people in terms of decision making when
in
they haven't
felt your
impact? In terms
of looking at your track record, exactly.
In terms of track record,
because your track record
that
you get, a track record where they overseas, we never get track records from you where concern your locality in terms of where
you're
from.
Oh, that will not be true. You go to say you don't know me now. Because you don't know me now. You don't imagine, say, all my experience now abroad level.
No, a lot of
but
them,
if you come down
actually
to my level, don't worry, I will still even lose my book. And I go begin to understand, say, I be a girl. You understand? Mm. So say I don't go abroad, do all all those abroad things and see life and everything for Ebola, no means say I come up from that my wire ghetto level. So leave her. I go soon understand, say I'll be delay, it delay, coco, it delay girl. Then I go stop all this talk saying our abroad levels. Most of our people know, say I'll be better country girl. When I those where they see me say I don't go abroad, I don't born children and do budo Ebola, they enjoy life. And then they think, say, I did that level where they say I cut out from the people where they here and I lie. But when I go soon discover, now question you ask, I answer you. So in terms of transferable skills and in terms of low-level politicking, you have to understand that I have analyzed it and I've seen in Nigeria, the only thing you learn to do when you start politicking from the bottom is to steal. You perfect the skills of looting. Most of these people you see in the councillor level, on the local government area level, on the houses level, they don't know anything about what politics is on that level. The only thing they know is, okay, this is the way that you get that money out, this is the way it comes in, this is where you take it to. They don't know anything about politics. They don't know anything about helping the environment, the communities, carrying people along. You see them buying shoes, oversized shoes for little kids in secondary schools, primary schools even. You see them giving out wrappers and giving out sewing machines and like very odd things in the name of doing community service. That's not what community service is all about. So if you tell me, okay, you need to go and gather experience on the bottom, you are actually not thinking about it holistically, because the people we put on that bottom, they don't do that. They actually only go there to perfect the skills of stealing. And I don't want to operate on that level. I've said, okay, in Nigeria, the presidential seat is a very powerful one, but it is one that has been seriously misused and mismanaged by all, or almost all, of the leaders we have had till today. When you are a president, you're supposed to look for ways to make life easier for everybody in the country, not serving particular interests or being unnecessarily dictatorial in the way you do things. As president, you can devolve power to the point where even at that local government area, there is serious effect. Because your president doesn't mean you have to do everything. It means you have to think about the best ways to get the right people working with you and make sure the dividends of democracy is properly passed down.
So talking about the best ways, Eunice, what are you bringing to the table?
Transparency and accountability. That is the biggest and the most crucial thing we need in Nigeria right now.
Yes, now you talk about transparency and accountability, of which you also come outside talk, say, at the councillor level, this one no actually there for there. So people, they come outside, they ask questions, say, if you know, say, there's a lacking in that level, why you no go there, go actually change the setting and that lacking and create the atmosphere for this accountability and transparency from that level?
Okay, now, if you go that level now, they try create accountability and prosperity, transparency, and Oga for top, they talk another language, you're wasting your time. What, because now waiting or guy for Ninja, things don't turn upside down. And if you don't begin to look things the unusual way, you go see nothing.
So you don't believe say if you come down from the
forget
roots?
From grassroots, what do you want to do when Oga don't give order? You know, hear what they tell you yesterday? Oga from above. They don't even know who passed the order. They just know it is from above. And then they carry mask and they went and stopped everybody from entering National Assembly. That's the way it works in Nigeria. That man at the grassroots has no power whatsoever. He cannot influence anything because everything depends on the guy at the top. And if that lady at the top is giving the wrong orders, it will pass down and everything will be done wrongly all the way to the bottom. But if that person is sitting there and saying, okay, well, now don't steal tire. I don't tire for this steal. Okay, now like this, we go do them. Camera go do everywhere. Oyibo, where they can't do contract negotiation with us for Niger, where camera, where microphone, anybody where they talk to, anything where they tell them, they record them. Anybody where they make you bring $10 million before you can't do your work for Niger, give us, we go deal with them. That's the way to start causing the change. Because it's coming from the top. All those ones at the bottom, they are so afraid to do anything wrong, they will do the things right. I experienced it already in the 6 months that Buhari was looking to put up his cabinet. The civil service was working perfectly. You will walk into the ministry and within 10, 15 minutes, you are done. You will come early, self, to go and sit down and wait as usual. 10 minutes to 8, the directors are there. The minister, DG, what are they called, self? They are there. And then you walk into their offices, 10, 15 minutes, you are done. What was the issue? They were afraid of the people that Oga will appoint. that will now become the minister. So they were doing things right automatically.
So tell us your agenda come this 2019.
You got to ask me questions. Because if you begin to talk agenda, I will give you 52 points agenda.
No, we'll talk about agenda. Uh-huh. Talk about agenda in layman terms. Not because in this situation where you talk of transparency and accountability, yes, it's quite vague. People need to understand your sketches.
In what ways?
In what ways? Give realistic ways. Because Nigerians now are getting tired of certain manifestos that are just on the surface. We need a breakdown. We need realistic solutions where if person hear them, they go say, oh, yes, I agree with your opinion, and for that reason, I'm standing by you come 2019.
I agree with you, but if you ask me a question generally like that, I may start from anywhere and everywhere, and I may end up giving you nothing, really. So it's easier when you say, okay, what do you have for us on health? What do you have for us on power? What do you have for us on education? What do you have for us on, you know, just pick something, and then I can help you there. But if you tell me what you, I can start talking about traditional rulers.
Let's look at the power and the health.
Power. Thank you. So in terms of power, I'm saying the government has done us a disservice by putting in regulations that make it impossible for people who are producing electricity to be transmitting and distributing. They make it necessary for the discos, that's the distribution companies, to be different from the production companies and different from the transmission companies. And what has that also done? They also did it that you must transmit to the national grid. Must. No matter
so
what
in
capacity.
Own, in your own capacity, wait till you say if you support.
Waiting at the top, they say we're supposed to change all those things. Make it be say anybody will get the money, get the ability to produce electricity, make it producer, make it transmitter, make it distributor.
Bagam. I like that.
When you want electricity, even if it can't be say, okay, national grid, they sell you for ₦1 per megawatt, but this one they sell them for ₦10. You know, say you want 24-hour lights, buy from the guy where they said ₦10, be sure. Because it goes still cheap past to the gold generator, they buy diesel and everything. And then national grid go, they serve the rural community. We don't get past that ₦1 per megawatt. You understand me? So rural community, if it no get 24-7, at least it go get more than which they get today. And then the businesses where they spent all this 5 trillion, 10 trillion, because they buy generator, they buy diesel and everything. They go just, they give their money to those companies where they distribute their energy direct to them. The day where they're not doing well, they sue them, collect even more money than what they lose.
Please, let me just come in here. I don't see you get lots of agenda.
Oh, and we're going to need to
do like a 2-hour interview with you for you to actually list them.
That's
out.
That's why I said we're going
to
ask a specific question.
And your pigeon, they're very top-notch.
Thank
so you need to just give them to us. Just stick to your pigeon.
Thank
I want
you.
Me to clarify something. Now,
yes.
Online, you see a lot of women coming out to attack you based on the particular tweet where you actually tweet, where you don't delete. But let me just read out the tweet so that you can clarify more what you mean. Now, you talk, say, I'm not a feminist, not by force. And who is a feminist? My friend who not go cook for her husband and kids because of equality, the one where go always insult men because she fit insult them, ladies who not go let man hold door for them because they feel, say, it bring down their value, waiting feminism mean. Now, I don't see a lot of platforms where this particular tweet, they display them, and a lot of women, they come outside attack you. Can you clarify on what you actually mean by this tweet?
What I meant and what I still mean is that I'm not a feminist. I don't attack issues from the perspective of a woman or to favor women first before anybody else, and then to coming in from the point of view that we women are already so disadvantaged, let us work to improve our situation before we start to look at all the other places. I go from the point of view, this is an issue, this is a problem, how do we tackle it? And tackle it from the point of view that everybody involved is disadvantaged, men, women, children, and then find a solution that favors everybody. Yes, indeed, women are highly disadvantaged, but it doesn't mean that every place you come to that it's the women that are disadvantaged. There are areas where you come to, and it's actually the men or the children who are disadvantaged. So I cannot come and be fighting from the perspective of being a woman or from the perspective of women are the ones suffering the most. I can't do that. And that's what mostly feminists do. They come from the point of view as women first and then everybody else equalize it because the women are seriously disadvantaged. I'm not saying it's wrong. All I'm saying is I don't operate that way. I operate from a point of view of truly we are all human beings and we are all equal and everybody deserves to have somebody fighting for them. Men,
fantastic.
Women, children.
Fantastic. Now, just the last one because of time, and we know say I wish we could keep it longer. I know a lot of your fans and a lot of your followers actually watch you now, and you get people way never they too sure about whether or not to actually vote for you to come 2019. What do you fit to tell them at this point in time for them that are watching you at home?
What in I fit tell them? I say me, you need say I did talk true. No matter where you see me, if you throw question for my body, the thing will come up for my mouth now the truth. You understand me? So if it be say you won't like me because you don't understand me, and you see say, okay, this woman, you know, go deceive you. And if you won't hate me because you don't look at say this woman, everything where they talk now, but I dey and I don't like him. But maybe say person tell you, another person tell you, just watch me, watch my space. I'm not in this race for 2019 alone. This is the rest of my life. I don't domot. You understand? Someone I just take it easy with me. I'm worth your votes. But if it takes me another 6 months to convince you, then I'm going to do that.
Thank you so much, Eunice Atuejide, 2019 presidential candidate.
Aspirant.
But we actually wish you all the best, and we hope to still have you here by the time when the proper declaration of the campaign starts. Let's see how your mandates they actually go.
Thank you very much.
All right, we're going to
enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.